What's up, everyone? Adrian Finch here, and I thought, what a better day than today to do an updated What's on my iPad Pro 2023 video. Lately, I've been really trying to just maximize the potential of this thing because I bought it, so I gotta milk it. So I'll show you all the exciting apps and new features and tools that I've been using to really turn this iPad into an absolute productivity machine. So let's go. So starting right off the bat with, of course, my favorite iPad accessories. You guys know I'm obsessed with Logitech. I pretty much use all of their stuff for everything. Also, shout out to Logitech for sponsoring today's video. So I have the iPad Pro 11 inch, and of course you can't have all this iPad without protecting it. So as always, I'm rocking my favorite Logitech Combo Touch keyboard / iPad case. I absolutely love this thing, okay? It's sturdy, it has a kickstand, which is crucial. And my favorite part is this easily attachable keyboard. Yeah, this seriously turns my iPad into like a mini Mac computer, and it even types like one, which is so nice because as a content creator, I feel like I'm constantly traveling or just working in places other than my house. I used to just bring my Logitech wireless keyboard and mouse with me on the go because they just connect so easily. But of course, this is so much easier now. This is such a versatile case, and there's literally 4 different ways to use it, so you actually can't go wrong. This is a next level accessory, guys. And then my next accessory, we have the newest Logitech crayon. I do have an Apple Pencil, but I wanted to test this out because it has the same Apple Pencil technology in it, but at only $69.99, it is a lot less expensive, so I figure what a good deal if this turns out to work just as well. Spoiler alert, it does. You literally just slide the on-off button down and you start writing right away. I actually looked at the instructions to see like how to connect it, and you don't even need to do anything. So you don't have to worry about Bluetooth or any like lags or fails. It just is ready to go. I was also given one of the brand new Combo Touch cases, and both that and this crayon are compatible with the 10th generation iPad. I actually have a second generation iPad Pro, but I am considering upgrading, so I'm definitely gonna hold on to the new case because it even has this cool little sleeve for the crayon, as well as some other updates. More on that later though. Let's open up the iPad. So starting with my lock screen, I actually made this on Canva, and I'll show you how to do this in a second, but I think it's so cute. And when I go ahead and open my iPad, this is what it looks like. I love revamping it. I'm very, very into this like bright aura kind of look we have going on. I only have 2 pages on my iPad. As you can tell on this very first page, this is of course like everything that I use kind of the most, but in the upper corner, we just have a widget. I just use Widgetsmith and kind of find some pictures on Pinterest and save them. Then you can just easily switch them out by like force touching, clicking edit widget, and choosing the one you want. This little clock widget is actually called Zen Flip Clock. I've had it for a while. I just think it's cute, honestly. And then we have the calendar widget. And then of course, just basic apps pretty much. Calendar, Spotify, YouTube, YouTube Studio. As you probably gathered, I'm a YouTuber. Cool. And then we have some editing apps that I use regularly on my iPad. So obviously we have Canva, like I mentioned, and I can show you how I made that wallpaper. I just found some random Instagram story template, and I think this design had some other text on it, like some quote, and I just changed it to July, saved it, and added it as wallpaper. I also sometimes use Canva for making other social media posts or logos. I've even made websites on Canva. If you want to check out a video tutorial, I'll link that down below. So another app that I use a lot for work is Photoshop. So I'll usually make my YouTube thumbnails in Photoshop. I often will do this part on the computer, but I love that I can do it on the iPad from anywhere. So literally I can just make everything here, cut myself out, add graphics, we can see all the layers, and then I'll pretty much just export this into Procreate. Oh my God, honestly, Procreate is like the sole reason I got an iPad. It is. So I'll make my thumbnails here, and then I'll usually export them directly to Procreate. So if we go ahead and open Procreate. Here it is. I like to just add arrows and fun things like that. I don't know, lines. You get the gist. I love using this app for so many things. Pretty much the sole reason I got this iPad was to be able to draw. Like, look at these freaking eyeballs. I've made a lot of backgrounds on here and just messed around. As you can see, just it's so easy to create hand-drawn elements, which I love. Drawing is also straight up therapeutic, okay? So this app rocks. And I love that I can lay my iPad flat, or I can put it in sketch mode like this. Another thing that I love doing if I want more of like a handwritten look on my videos is actually animate text using Procreate. I like to turn on the drawing guide and the animation assist, but then pretty much just draw like whatever I would want. And this Logitech crayon has a smart tip. So as you can see, you can write and draw naturally without any lag, and that's pretty epic. This is how you get that wiggly effect, is you kind of just keep adding layers and drawing over the top. You can add as many or as few as you want. See, just like that. And one of my favorite things about this, which is so random, is the shape, the fact that it's like kind of a carpenter's pencil and it's flat. Let me tell you the amount of times that I have put my pencil down and it has rolled off the table or something else onto pavement in a gas station and got run over by a car. That's a true story. But anyway, once the animation is complete, we would just go up to the gear icon and share it as an animated HEVC or MP4 or PNG, whichever one I'm trying to use. And then I would basically airdrop it to my laptop to put it on a video in Final Cut. Now, if I want to edit a video on my phone or my iPad, I actually always use CapCut. But if you do happen to have a 10th generation iPad, Final Cut Pro finally came out with an iPad app. You're actually able to draw directly onto an edit and animate it from there, which is so cool and a huge reason why I see an upgrade in my future. This brings me to the next app that I use a lot on here, which is CapCut. CapCut is by far my favorite video editing app for mobile, so iPad or iPhone. You can do so many different things like add captions for free and things like that. And also on CapCut, you can actually draw directly on videos as well. So if you actually click on text and then draw, you can pick any sort of pen style, an arrow. You can also animate it. So that's pretty nice. Obviously that's random, but you get the gist. So CapCut, I love. I make most of my reels and TikToks and YouTube shorts on there. And then we have Lightroom, which I do love to use for editing photos, but I really don't post that many photos anymore. So I feel like there's not a whole lot of like heavy photo editing that I do on here. But anyway, speaking of writing and drawing, since we're kind of on the topic, the next app that I absolutely love to use is GoodNotes. I'm sure you guys have heard of this a million times, but it's a note-taking app. You can also import PDFs or documents. You can highlight, you can write things, you can type things. So it's really great for all sorts of things. What I use it the most for is just planning my day-to-day. I have multiple different kinds of planners on here. You can buy planners for pretty cheap on Etsy, and they also now have their own GoodNotes shop, which is really interesting. They don't have many free templates, which I wish there were more of, but they do have a ton of paid planners, covers, different paper, which is cool. So essentially this is just like a customizable notebook that's pretty much never ending. I love using a digital planner because it's just better for the environment and it's really easy to like move things around and use stickers and just write out everything that you're gonna do. And what a better time than now to use your keyboard, because you can also type notes. So that makes things a lot easier. I love GoodNotes. Another random app that I have is Wibble, and this is great for making animated GIFs that you can use for Instagram story stickers and things like that. The next app on here is called Parrot, and this is actually a teleprompter app that I use when I am filming main channel videos, except for not right now, of course, because I have my iPad right here. This has helped so much with like long sit-down talking videos. This app was free. I basically just connect it to a Bluetooth remote that I have, and then it reflects on this glass, and I'm able to look right into the camera but actually read the text. So I love this thing, and it definitely comes in handy. I always thought that looking into a teleprompter would be obvious in the video, but you honestly can't tell at all, so that's pretty sick. And then I also have this clock phone app. So this is sort of like a screensaver that I just think is really cute. Honestly, there's really no point to it other than that, but I really like it. And then down here, I've talked about this before, but I have this little mood widget, which I think is just cute, called the Daily Bean. So you can just kind of like log how you feel. And this widget is another just photo that I saved from Pinterest, which is down below in this bar. As you can see, I've got my browser, Pinterest, basically just all of that stuff. So that's page number one. Moving on to page number two, honestly, I don't use these that often. This is where I store all of the Apple apps that I don't really use, as well as other work apps that I do sometimes use. iFont is really great if you want to import fonts onto your iPad. You can actually do so through this app. That way on GoodNotes and things like that, you can have custom fonts. So you would just airdrop them to here, import them here and install them. And then another kind of cool app that I have is called Coolers. I think. This is like a color palette app, so you can literally just generate random color palettes and save any that you like. So this definitely inspires me, or if I'm doing any graphics or thumbnails, I love just like looking around at these. But yeah, that's pretty much it there. I've got shopping, I've got entertainment, Goodreads and Libby are like my favorite reading apps. And then I also have Canon Camera Connect. This app is awesome because my camera has a Wi-Fi setting enabled. So if I kind of sync that up with this app, I can actually use it as a monitor, make sure I'm in focus, make sure I like the shot and actually click record from here since my camera is about 10 feet back there. So this is really, really handy for being a content creator. If I'm ever shooting without my teleprompter, then I can use it as a monitor. If not, I can use my computer as a monitor, but either way, I love it. This is the Actions app, by the way. I've talked about this a million times, so I'm not gonna get into it, but I just absolutely love this app for basically planning any and all tasks that fall into different kind of buckets. And then I just have three more widgets below: weather, this habit tracker, and clock phone app. There's two more really cool things that I've been using my iPad for. Number one is I can actually use it as a monitor or an extension of my laptop. So I do use a big monitor when I'm editing, but if I'm ever on the go, I love being able to extend my monitor and actually have more than one screen. It's pretty wild that this iPad can do that. And then the second thing is actually a little hack that I didn't know you could do. If you go into your settings and then your control center and you add the hearing button, then once you connect an audio device, if you click on the ear, you can actually turn on background noises. So that's pretty cool if you want to focus and you're doing work and you have your headphones on or you're at a coffee shop on the go and you can actually just have some white noise built directly in your iPad. So that pretty much does it for what's on my iPad right now and how I kind of use it for work as a content creator and a business owner. Both the Logitech case and crayon have just come in handy so much. I don't know what I would do without them. So if you want to check out either of those products, I highly recommend. I will link them down below. I say this so much, but I'll say it again. I just love Logitech's products because they really adapt into your life. You don't have to change your life or your workflow to fit the products. The products really, really fit your life. And this crayon uses the same USB-C charging little port as the iPad Pro, the iPad Air, and the new iPad, as well as my older MacBook. So these tools are incredible. I highly recommend. Check out the link. And if you want to see more iPad or Apple product related videos, click on the playlist right here. And to subscribe, click right here. Thank you guys so much for watching. And thank you, Logitech, for sponsoring this video. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Notice I've been touching this pencil the entire time I've been filming.